Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, make sure you hit this Taco Bell sign to get your notifications sent straight to your email or straight to your phone so you will not miss a beat when I upload my material. And also to get to my platforms, on my social media platforms, everything is up at the top right in the right hand corner below. So let's go ahead and get right into the action. What's up, everybody? And welcome to another segment of The Matrix with your boy Prime. Glad y'all can officially join me on this lovely, lovely Tuesday afternoon. Now, we have some significant information that was dropped to us today. And I really want to get the community's personal outlook. I want to get your feel. You can actually state this in the comment section below. If you choose not to, that's fine as well. But I really want to have everybody, I really want to get everybody's feedback and outlook on this situation. Now, today, the NBA, the PR department, public relations, they went ahead and they put out a statement today pertaining to the expansion of partnership with the NBA pertaining to video games. Now, this is highly significant because the last one that was signed was back in 2011 when EA Sports and Take-Two simultaneously signed this document. Now, I think it's a 10-year docket or a 10-year contract. Now, within that 10-year contract, you still have to make you using the license to use the not the players associations and the NBA brand over that time. Now, as of today on January the 15th, which is today, Take-Two had announced, and I'm going to let y'all see it right here, is that they have officially got a new contract, and they announced it today to a multi-year global partnership extension. Now, this, and as y'all are reading this right here, this extension goes for a set for the series for the past 17 years. Okay, so this extension is going to enable them to add, it's going to a significant amount of not only signature partnerships and everything pertaining to the NBA. This sustains their notoriety as the power for NBA gaming. Now, we know NBA Live has officially came back, but NBA Live has not given a statement, or Electronic Arts has not been on this statement. Now, I'm just going to read it out and let everybody go from there. And then y'all can tell me exactly how y'all feel about this as y'all looking at the gameplay in the back. Now, the NBA, the National Basketball Association, and the National Players Association, and 2K has swarly owned label of Take-Two Interactive Software and publisher of the leading global basketball video game NBA 2K. Today announced a significant multi-year global partnership extension. The agreement expands upon the success of NBA 2K, the top-rated and top-selling NBA video game simulation series for the past 17 years that has sold in more than 86 million units worldwide. Now, the NBA has been an outstanding partner throughout the history of the NBA, of the NBA 2 franchise, contributing significantly to its unparalleled success and the ability to grow its audience around the world across a myriad of platforms and earnings. Now, Chairman and CEO of Take-Two, we're thrilled to be in business with Adam and the entire team at the NBA and enter into the longest ever partnership extension between our organizations. Together, we're confident that we'll continue to find new and innovative ways to capture and engage basketball fans and expand further the success of the NBA 2K brand. NBA 2K recently launched NBA 2K19 after setting a series record for 2K18 with 10 million units sold this year, makes the 20th anniversary of the video game franchise. Now, an entire generation of basketball fans engage and connect with NBA teams and players throughout NBA 2K, said NBA Commissioner Adam Silver. We are grateful to extend our partnership with Take-Two and the NBA Players Association to build on their enormous popularity of NBA 2K franchise and the continued global growth of basketball. I'm just going to skip past this part, but it said other facets of the partnership include 2K Online, 2K Online 2, which together have 40 million registered users, and the number one PC online sports game in China. In addition, 2K recently published NBA 2K Playgrounds 2, NBA 2K Mobile, and launched a groundbreaking NBA 2K League in May of 2018. Now, ladies and gentlemen, now, EA has not came out with a statement. They have not came out with anything just yet. Now, we know that EA is going to bring out something. But what does this mean? Because they signed a very, very big deal. And this is a very, very, very big significance. And I'm just going to let y'all know my outlook on this. Do I feel that NBA Live as a franchise is in trouble? Do I feel that NBA Live is going to be gone after this, or do I feel that NBA Live is in between? I would say in between, because all I know is this, that NBA Live isn't going anywhere. However, what does EA have in store for the NBA Live franchise moving forward? Because we know their foundation and their focus was actually this right here. I'm going to let y'all see this. And let y'all see it for yourselves. And y'all go by what it... Now, there was... You know what? Let me state this. If y'all did the Reddit survey, if y'all decide to do it, if you care for it, if you decide to do it or not, but on the Reddit survey, this is what it actually said on their focus on what you played the most. Now, this is kind of head-scratching to me because it doesn't have nothing else that a lot of players want. They basically suggested and stated, what did you play the most? And anything that you might play the most is in an other column. Me as a head-to-head player and primarily gameplay person, that's what I care for. These are the only options that they gave on what they want you to look at. I put other. And I think other is going to be the primary one for a lot of players, because I think a lot of players out there, they didn't say anything about LUT. They didn't say nothing about franchise. They didn't say nothing about head-to-head. They didn't say nothing about actual game tournaments. They primarily focused on the one, court battles, live run, and so forth. And as you saw in that picture. So, I want to get y'all outlook as a community. And I want to know exactly how you feel about this in its entire. Do you feel that EA is in trouble because of this announcement? Do you feel that EA needs to do some changes? Do you feel that EA Sports, you know, with them handling the NBA Live franchise, what do you feel that the direction should go moving forward? You know, I'm not going to give my two P's on it, but I really want to hear you, the community, and I want to know exactly how you feel. Gladly subscribe to the channel. I truly would appreciate it. This is the number one spot for all your NBA Live material. Hey, if you don't believe me, check out my channel. My resume speaks for itself. Also, make sure y'all hit me up on Twitter, y'all, or Facebook. You will never know, or Instagram. You will never know what's going down unless you're following me. You have your notifications on, and you will never know what's going on unless you are following me on these platforms. And also make sure that you subscribe to the channel as well. All right, y'all. I'm out of here, and y'all have a blessed one. Peace.